Welcome for the first time in Jeux sans frontières to Yugoslavia. The games tonight come from the town of three presenters, and we have three of them tonight. The girl there is Dunja, with her long blonde tresses floating gently in the breeze. And the men. Dragon, with the grey hair brushed well back, who will co-present with Dunja. He looks a little like Nelson Eddy. And there's Minja, and he'll present the fil rouge. And now here come the teams from that ship, which is moored on the banks of the Danube, looking beautiful and floodlit tonight. And first of all, we have the Belgian team, would you believe, of Silly. I think they might call it CE. It's a little town some 15 miles north of Mons, and it's famous for its silkware. And now from up in the Alps in Switzerland, the town of Altdorf. You all know it, it's top of the Gotthard Pass, and it is famous, of course, as the birthplace and the scene of the adventures of William Tell. And now in the pale blue, from Germany, the team of Lahnstein, a little mining town situated at the junction of the rivers Rhine and Lahn, and their population is 23,000. Now from France, a team you'll all know, the team of Fontainebleau, because knockout bus will have seen them at least three times. Last year they won an international, they came to the final at Ludwigsburgen, came third. A very, very strong team, and they are co-favourites tonight. Getting a rapturous welcome from not only the crowd here of some 10,000 Yugoslavs, but about 500 Brits who come down to see them, the team of Sandwell, representing Great Britain, the largest anonymous metropolitan borough in the country. 300,000 people live there, and they are co-favourites and determined to put Sandwell well and truly on the map tonight. Now the Italian team of Torfa. They're a famous little town about 35 miles north of Rome, famous for their craftsmen, especially in leather. We don't expect them to do well tonight, but you never can tell with the Italians. Getting a fantastic reception because this is the first time a Yugoslav team have appeared on the home soil, the first international ever in Yugoslavia, the home team of Zemun. The town, as we tell you, of 100,000 people right here on the banks of the River Danube, and listen to this crowd going mad. Now to the first game, after the introductions and all the preamble, let's get down to it. Six teams are going, and the French of Fontainebleau, a very strong team, are playing their joker along with the Italians of Torfa. There's the arena, the chessboard, two boys and a girl. The two boys on the whistle will go straight up the chessboard and pick up two wheels with which to make a chariot. There are the wheels in front of the giant pawn. Straight up the arena they go. And off like lightning are the two British boys. The two boys, Peter Millard, Raymond Morris, coming back with the wheels, they have to make a chariot. On the chariot then sits a girl from the team. It's a very, very flimsy contraption indeed, but Yugoslavia away. First away, Italy, Yugoslavia, France on the joker, then Britain, last Germany. First round the marker is Fontainebleau. Fontainebleau have got it together. They detach one man, they come back down to the course. Fontainebleau in the lead. Fontainebleau doing well. Coming right in, they're going to win it. Fontainebleau, I have won it, but who's going to come second? It's going to be British. Britain are coming in number two. Britain number two, this is Steve Millard and Hazel. But Yugoslavia catching up, the French have won it. The game finishes, as you can see, when the light goes on the top of the pole, lights up, because the national flag has reached there. Up goes the Union Jack. The Union Jack's going up now to finish second behind the French of Fontainebleau. Up is going the flag of Yugoslavia. Yugoslavia going to finish third, but the British are celebrating having come second. What a fantastic race. But in the meanwhile, back at the race, which you won't see at the moment, we have the Italians just coming in. In the excitement and the furore of that race, the German flag is going up, so the Germans will finish in fourth place. The order: France, Britain, Yugoslavia, Germany, Switzerland, Italy.
First place,
France, on the joker, 12 points on the nose, Fontainebleau, off to a flying start.
Sandwell,
Drugi, that means second. We're learning Serbo-Croat as we go along.
Lahnstein, fourth.
Switzerland, fifth place.
Lahnstein were fourth, Altdorf fifth, and Torfa were sixth place. And
Torfa
the points.
Na šestom mestu.
The points.
I sada bodovi.
France with the joker, 12 points.
12 points for Fontainebleau. A racing start. They've come here to win as well.
The two favorites, Sandwell, 5 points for Sandwell.
Yugoslavia,
not bad at all.
4 points.
4 points Zemun, for the Yugoslavs of Zemun.
Germany, 3 points.
Landstein, 3 points.
Landstein, 3.
Switzerland, 2 points.
Altdorf, 2 points.
Altdorf,
and Tofer, only 1 point.
Joker,
we're racing.
Itolfa,
and
sa,
the lovely Phil Rouge to come, and Eddie.
Thank you.
Well, Sandwell could have done well to have had the Joker on that, but they didn't, and they can't do it on this one, although the first team to do is Belgium, and limit time is 1 minute 45 seconds. So you'll now see it unfold as the boat starts to go forward and backwards, of course, and one man it is, job is to push it. Got to catch it and move it out. So the castle, the knight, and the castles. And the Blue Danube, which is right behind that particular set piece. We went for a trip on the Danube during the day, and it certainly aroused a lot of interest. First time, of course, we've been in Yugoslavia, and it's a question of now catching the football. Silly, we could say silly Belgium, but they seem to be doing all right. Population nearly 6,000, 15 miles from Mons, very picturesque, and with a variety of castles, and the castle is there, the knight is in front, and the castle on the right. One man dodges around the back, pushing the boat. 1 minute 45 seconds, and no joker. The man at the back is regarded as an important one for the first one. He's spending a lot of time with the first one anyway. And it's Mark, Eddie, Alain, Marie, and Martin. And 10 seconds to go, which will be, as we have often said, par for the course, use a different sport. Certainly a lot of people down here who are interested in the chess business. And now comes the point of decision. And for the first team, Belgium.
8 balls.
8 balls for Belgium. So that's the first Phil Rouge to the second game, Stuart.
Well, thank you, Eddie. They're the Belgian team. Four pawns, two boys and two girls and a bishop. Go diagonally, and Sandwell are playing their joker. Two English gentlemen are playing the joker. So make a note of this. We're playing our joker. It involves two boys and two girls as pawns and one as a bishop going diagonally up the course. They vault over each other. This is the Belgian team. We're not interested in the Belgian team of silly at the moment, but coming in the other direction, there you are, in the red, are the British team. They vault over each other as fast as you can, diagonally on the course. And when the one dressed as the bishop vaults over the last one, they make a run for the castle. That's the Belgian team. Ignore the Belgian team. Going in the opposite direction are the British. Here comes the... That's the bishop. That's the bishop. And when they go to the castle. In the castle goes the bishop. He pushes the castle over while another member moves the steps, and he comes onto the square next to the king. The king mounts the stairs. That's our British king. He goes into the castle, out of the castle, down the other side when the steps arrive, and the castle and the king have changed squares. When that happens, the steps go back to where they originally came from, in a corner of the arena. They're going back as fast as possible, into a red square, into a little garage, and the teams then line up, and they finish. The British team have finished. Meanwhile, enjoy the game with the Belgians. We make the time for the British team, 58 seconds, which is lightning. Now sit back and enjoy the game with the Belgians. The Belgians have finished now.
A very risky game to play a joker, and I do hope they're right.
Why is that, Eddie?
Because there's a lot of complications and permutations, and a lot of people doing it.
Silly, minute and 9 seconds.
And for Great Britain, 58 seconds.
Sandwell, velika razlika, 58 seconds.
Attention. Pashnya, 3, 2, 1.
And this is the moment of truth. Heat 2, the French in the bottom right-hand corner. In the French team.
two officers from the French army and a corporal, and two strapping girls, and can they beat the Sandwell time? Because already, emerging as favourites tonight, we have the French team of Fontainebleau and the magnificent super team of Super Sandwell. Watch the French. The Germans going in the opposite direction. But look at the physique of the French. Here comes the French bishop. When he's vaulted over, he goes into the castle, remember? They push the castle over to the king's square. The king comes in, mounts the steps, goes inside the castle, and the castle and the king have changed squares. If you find the chess allusions a bit confusing, then forget the chess. Just concentrate on the game and the costumes. And a beautiful international for the first time here in Yugoslavia. It's a wonderful night, beautiful balmy air, and Sandwell the favourites. But the Germans in the light blue, and there you can see the costumes quite clearly. And the French time. We make it possibly 1 second outside the British time, and this is crucial because we're playing a joker.
Of 1:06.
Lunchtime, minute and 6 seconds.
And France, 59 seconds.
Fontainebleau,
and the cheers going up from the 500 Brits in the audience here at Zemun. And the third heat. We don't expect much from the Italians. They come here to enjoy life. And coming in the opposite direction, the Yugoslavs. You've got the game by now, the vault average, and there could now be a collision, they're on collision course, and it is. That's good news. It's a bit unfair, but we like it. It's good news for Britain and for Sandwell. We could do with a few more collisions. You've got the game by now, here comes the bishop. When he's vaulted over the last one, they all pile in, shove the castle, bring the steps. In goes the king, out to the side, change squares. And we don't fancy either of these two teams to beat the British time, so it's possible. We've won our joker and 12 points. The Yugoslavs getting a wonderful reception. A terrific audience here of 10,000. The first international played in Yugoslavia, and he looks a bit dodgy. Always rely on the Italians to give you the fun when they're playing away. Playing at home is a different matter, but playing away, lots of fun, lots of smiles. And they all line up neatly. End of game, time is taken. Let us observe. Nowhere near
so
the Sandball time.
Italy a time of 1:15 seconds.
Tolfa, 1:15.
And for Yugoslavia, 1:06 seconds.
Zemun, minute and 6 seconds.
Same time as Lunchtime for Zemun. The points.
With the joker, 12 points.
This is terrific.
12
points for Sandwell. But they're not far behind. Fontainebleau with 5.
Fontainebleau, 5.
And already these two teams emerging as the great rivals. Strong Fontainebleau, the army team. Sandwell coming here to prove points. The largest anonymous borough in the whole of Great Britain. And they want to put Sandwell well and truly on the map. We'll see how the whole evening unfolds. But at the moment, in the lead, equal first with Fontainebleau, we have Sandwell. And the printout will make rejoicing news with the fanfare. And Eddie, with you on the Fil Rouge.
Thank you. What a great start that was for Sandwell. Who knows? With a good Fil Rouge, they may be going for a place of number one. Time alone will tell, but they don't go until the fifth Fil Rouge. It's team we're looking at now, Aldo from Switzerland. And just to recap on the rules, the balls have got to be put to the man in his little boat. Then must be passed in front of the knight, not behind, clearly taken, and then passed up and down into the long sock. Silly, the first team to go, got 8 balls, and it's hauled off to go, and a very popular little town of very good competitors near the south end of Lake Lucerne, a population of 7,000, and seen of the adventures of William Tell, who I'm sure never thought anything like this. The castle, the knight, and the castle. And it's quite important for the pusher to get the right point of impact for the ball to be caught. The man throwing the ball is an electrician, and then the man receiving it is an apprentice electrician. 2-4-6, 30 seconds to go. They've got to beat 8 if they want to go in front of Silly, Switzerland. But Sandwell got off to a very, very good start with their joker, and the crowd, a tremendous crowd, and Sandwell fans really on ball tonight. Time, and we make it 11. We'll see whether that is right. 11 it is, 11 balls for Switzerland. That is Sandwell to go 5th place, and Stewart.
Thank you.
Well, thank you very much, Eddie. We come now to the game of the Flying Bishop. And up on the left of the screen there, you see Mr. Paul Lippiot of Sandwell and Great Britain, equipped with 8 rings and standing on roller skates. The Flying Bishop has to come down the course, which is 45 meters long, and he has to lasso 8 points. When he's lassoed them, a light goes on at the top. There you see it, and those Dracula characters are there just to make sure that the light does go on, and if it doesn't, they put their hands up. 8 rings he's got to lasso in the shortest possible time, and he'll be off on his way. But first of all, we have the Belgian joker coming in, and also the Swiss. Altdorf, the birthplace of Willem Tell on the right, and see that little town near Mons from Belgium on the left. 2 jokers being played, and it could be risky. On the other hand, their competitor might be an ace roller skater, which Mr. Paul Lippiot isn't. He's a self-confessed non-roller skater. He's looked dodgy. In fact, he even forgot his roller skates. He forgot to bring them to Yugoslavia, had to borrow a pair. But let's see how he does. He comes down. Does he get one? One, and the light goes on. He stumbles to grade 2, misses it. This is absolutely crucial. He must get a few. 2, he's 2. He has 2. He missed that one, just 2 so far. He's 8 to go at. 3, he's got 3. He's missed that. He's only got 2 more left. Can he get that? Yes, he gets it. And he finishes, but he's not. And he goes straight over the restraining wall at the end. But not a good run by Paul. This is our weakest game tonight.
We have 5 rings.
Only 5 rings. And limit time is 25 seconds. There you have the French bishop. There's the English contingent. But the Frenchman there is Monsieur Le Duc, and he's an expert roller skater. You see the way he comes down, slowing himself down. He could get a full house here. 1, 2, 3, taking his time. His bags of time to get to the end of the ramp. 4, could it be 5? No, he's missed it. A bit of luck. 4, 5, 6, 7.
He got on.
So nobody in limit time so far, but the 2 great rivals here tonight, Sandwell and Fontainebleau, have had their runs.
The score for France, 7
5
rings.
For GB, 7 for France. The Swiss, on the joker. Monsieur Arnold is a mechanic from Altdorf. What can he do? Do your own counting from now on. Four. Missed it. Just 4. 5, 6, 7. We make it. But of course, one light didn't go on. It could even be 6.
Switzerland, we have 6 rings.
Yes, 6 rings. But still, the worst run of all, Sandwell. An Italian there, Giuseppe. What can he do?
Attenzione, 3, 2, 1.
We'd like him to get less than 5, and he doesn't look too safe at the moment. He's all over the place, all arms and legs. He's, yes. And I love the disguise. That's the. He must have been at the camp. He must have been. He just shows the great anxiety to get rid of the rings at all costs. Paul Zatolfa. Well, we rely on the Italians to give us the laughs away from home.
Yes, for Italy, we have 5 rings.
So, at least we're not bottom. We're equal bottom so far. 5 rings for Tolfa. Yugoslavia will go next.
That's a smashing shot which shows you the incline. And listen to the crowd. You don't have to exhort this Yugoslav crowd. They give you everything. Not just for the Yugoslav competitors, but for the lot. Oh! Oh, he's going potty. Oh! Yes! Another Italian run. Oh! And oh dear, and he's off. He's rather furious with himself. But he's still getting a little applause despite that awful run. Let's hope he's just got four rings.
Only four rings.
Yes, he has. So lucky Sandwell. They were jammy there. They had appalling run on the first round, but the Yugoslavs have shown them that it could even be done more badly. Last will go the Belgians on their joker. And we should see some clever roller skating from this guy here, taking his time. No! Missed the first one. He's got the second one, but the light didn't go on. Third one, yes. Four. Five. Already beaten Britain. Six. Seven. Has he got the full house? A light didn't go on. We make seven in the commentary box, but confirmation will come from Gennaro. Only six.
Silly, six. Obruchava.
So, bad news for Britain, the French have won it.
6 points.
Watch this French team, they're out of the boat holes and away.
Then Switzerland with the
out of the first three games, they've won two and come second.
Belgium with the joker, 10 points.
10 points for City on the joker.
Italy, 3 points.
Italy, 3 points, and very luckily, I fear, we've picked up our 3 points.
Sandwell is Totolico, 3.
And Zemun just picking up one.
Yugoslavia, only 1 point.
But already the favourites, we keep stressing it. It's a match here between Fontainebleau and Sandwell. There's the fanfare. Don't despair, the Fil Rouge to come and Eddie.
Achtung, 3, 2, 1.
Jamais to go in the third Fil Rouge, Dornstein. And a lot of chess is played, of course, in Belgrade, which is only a couple of miles down the road from Zenum, which is the hometown team. Chasing 8 and 11. Mine in town, situated at the junction of the rivers Rhine and Lahn, population of 23,000, a 13th century castle and a spa town. And the theme song, obviously, is going to be the Danube. I reckon the team that could get 15 here in this Fil Rouge could be sitting near the top of the table. The Germany coin, the third Fil Rouge. Quite easy to pass, of course, the round ball. I wonder what would have happened if they'd had the oval-shaped ball. But not getting on, 30 seconds. And watching carefully the German team. They now got the rhythm, 2, 4, about 6. Not a lot of time to get past the silly Belgium's 8. 10 seconds to go. Got to get the rhythm going faster, no doubt. Sandwell will be looking, spying out how to do this. And the whistle goes, and it looks around 8 to us, but we wait for the official time.
For Germany, 8
and official
balls.
Score. Time, incidentally, 1:45 seconds and 8 for Germany. So Switzerland leading at this moment. Stuart.
Well, thank you, Eddie. There you see a magnificent castle and jokers coming in from Yugoslavia. There's a Zemun joker, and in the first heat will go the Germans and the Swiss. It's a very clever game, this, because you've two guys on a chariot and a fellow in the front. The fanfare plays from the ramparts of the castle, and chess players will be familiar with this game, which I shall explain to you, but first of all, they have to barge down a door. If on the other side of the door a light goes on, it means there's a queen's costume in there, and that fellow there has to change himself from a pawn into a queen. In other words, he's got to put on the queen's costume. And you can see he's standing at the end
of that pole, which is marked red. He can't move off there, he has to balance himself, and if he falls off, he falls in the drink. He's in! The German in the drink, and when he falls in the drink, the costume gets wet and even more difficult to put on. On the other side, you see the Swiss having a rather torrid time. Now, he's not allowed to put that costume on. He should be standing on the... that's where our British judge coming in and telling him to get back on the pole. The game is changing the pawn into a queen. It's a classic chess move. And you know that... Well, yes, on the other side, the Swiss is in the drink again. Let's explain the move and get rid of it for chess players. Because, you know, when you play the opposition, when your pawn reaches the back line of the chessboard, the pawn changes into a queen. And you can then play with two queens, or if you get two pawns up, you can play with three queens. But having got the queen's costume on, they come back with the chariot. The queen, complete with wig and dress, jumps on the podium, and the time is taken. That's the German. Here comes the Swiss. It's a very clever game. You have to guess which door the Queen's costume is behind. It's a clever game of guessing. And when you've guessed, you've got to put on the costume. When you put on the costume, you'll hair back down the course to the podium. Beautifully constructed chariots and the castle out of magnificent pine. The Yugoslavs have really built a fantastic set here in Zemun. Now the times.
For Switzerland, 1:59.
Vreme za Altdorf, minut 59.
And for Germany,
1:59 for the Swiss of Altdorf. And what about the Germans? The Yugoslavs are going next on this game. And how can you play the joker on a guessing game? You have three doors to guess at. You must be absolutely accurate and guess first time. Otherwise, you have to waste time coming back to take another run at the stockade. Watch carefully the Yugoslavs on the joker. Which door will they go for? The left, the right, or the middle? We're bound to see it from the director here. Will they guess right? The Italians haven't guessed right, but the Yugoslavs have. Now, how on earth have they done that? They must have something mystical. ESP or something to guess the right door because the Italians are booed. But the Yugoslavs have guessed right first time. It's a matter now of putting on the costume. The Yugoslavs on their joker. And he's in. He's got to put his frock down at the back, put his wig on. We're going in the third heat. The French don't go. And if we win, it's our chance to overhaul the French. 3 points behind at the moment, trailing Sanwell. These two great teams. Here come the Yugoslavs back for a tremendous time. Off on the podium. Forgotten the wig, wasted three or four valuable seconds. The time is taken when the competitor's on. And leaders to say, who's giving us the laughs but Tolfer? Let's watch him. A combination of Old Queen, Bonjour Matelot, Santa Claus and the lot. He's in again. Well, listen in the background, this wonderful Yugoslav crowd. It's the first time, obviously, that we've heard a Yugoslav crowd because we've never played here before. It's the first international. And incidentally, Yugoslavia, the newest country to play knockout. They were only formed in 1918 when six provinces came together. So it's a magical night, a night of firsts. And can Britain be the first country to win on Yugoslav soil? But in the meantime, he's going to drown himself. He's getting really peeved. This poor chap here, Angelo Capone. He's got to be Capone, copping the lot. He's 30 seconds to go, and he's... Well, they must have trained on. It's inevitable he's got to go. He's trained up on Chianti. He's losing his knee pads, which could cop him a nasty one on the derriere if he falls on it, but never mind. So see, where is he? He's bound to go yet again. Go on. No, he's gone.
I kraj. Vreme predviđeno za ovu igru. 2:30 je isteklo.
A bedraggled moustache. It spoke volumes, that Italian face. I love the Italians when they play abroad. Wunderbar. But look at the Zemun time, the Yugoslav 1:08. That will take some whacking on the joker game. But now the British are going Colin Jewis, Brian Lewis, heaving the chariot, the fanfare's play. John Collins is our queen. Will we guess right? I'd go for the middle door if I were the Brits. I'd go for the middle one. What have we done? Have we gone for the middle one? Let's have a look. Have the lights gone on? Have we got the Queen's costume? It's absolutely vital because the Belgians have made a mess of it. They've gone for the wrong door. Yes, we've gone for the middle. We got it. That's what we'd have gone, and we'd have dropped a burner if they'd gone for the left or the right, but they've hit it first time. It's absolutely vital to be in the first door that you hit. John Collins is there putting on the Queen's costume, and the Belgians are guessed wrong again. They're having to go for the right-hand door. They've belted down, first of all, the left. That was wrong. The middle, that was wrong. That's the right-hand door. In they go. The light goes on. In they go for the Queen's costume. There's John Collins. He's coming back. What a fantastic time. It's 55 seconds so far. Pursuing a time of the Yugoslavs at 1-0. Can we come in? Can we win it? We're going to win it. He's on in less than a minute. Well, there are the Sandwell cheerleaders and the reserves and the supporters emoting in the meanwhile, groping his way. Is this young man from C? Well, some inspired running there by Colin and Brian pulling the chariot, and John Collins, who's obviously done a bit of this costume changing before, studied Danny LaRue very carefully. Well, we think we've won it, so you can sit back and enjoy it. And if we have, we pick up 6 points and go 3 points in front of Fontainebleau, and already it's a two-horse race. But he's coming back. The Belgians of Sili coming back. Game finish on the podium. He's on with the wig, time taken, and now let's listen carefully. Have Sandwell won it?
So the time for Belgium, 1:48 seconds.
Sili, minut I 48 secondi.
And Great Britain,
here it is.
1:01.
You're in there, you can hear the cheers in the background. 1:01, 6 points.
Odnosno, konačno najbolje vreme.
The point, Great Britain, 6 points.
Great Britain.
Sandwell, 6 points.
6 points.
Yugoslavia with Joker, 10 points.
Zemun,
well, this is incredible. For Sandwell in game one, Germany, 5 points. In game two, 12 points. Game three, 3 points. Game four, 6 points. This is absolutely winning form. Sandwell, a tremendous team, magnificently led. Absolutely fit. Team of extroverts doing well. Could give us our first win this year. Here's the printout on the fanfare. And it's great stuff. Sandwell, 26. Fontainebleau, 23. Zemun, 19. Sili, 15. And Eddie with you.
Well, Sandwell supporters are really encouraging them along, and the next go route could be a most important one, because this is Fontainebleau, and they're at the top with Sandwell. So the chances here, if they can be kept to 11 or 12, who knows? It may be Sandwell, because they go after Fontainebleau. Duration 1:45, and just for their occupation, which a lot of people often ask us what they are. Well, we've got a PE teacher, a gymnastic teacher, we've got a soldier, and a teacher and a student. And they probably do the swinging to the tune of the Blue Danube. Could be rather slow in process, but no doubt they've been watched carefully. And Fontainebleau, which of course a town you know about, popular resort, River Seine, 35 miles southeast of Paris. And of course, the famous building, the palace, where Napoleon signed his abdication. So a little bit of a history. It's rather important now for Sandwell, who are sitting at the top and looking good. Their supporters are really giving them a lot of encouragement. They're obviously reacting to this. 30 seconds to go. 2:45, we reckon. If we can keep it under 12, I think that Sandwell, with the enthusiasm that's prevailing right throughout the team and the competition now, will get a valuable Phil Rouge win. Time will tell. 10 seconds only. 2, 4, 6, 8, 9, 10 possibly. Is this one in? Now we're guessing that won't count, but 10 or 11. Probably 11, in which case I think that would be a very good target for Sandwell to chase
11
and
balls.
Pass. We shall know very quickly
11.
Because after the next game with Stewart will come what could be the decisive Phil Rouge and Stewart.
Thank you, Eddie. Game number 5 is chess basketball. That's the goalkeeper in the net, and he's from Yugoslavia. There are the French girls, who two big strapping girls as well, and they have to hurl as many balls into his net as possible. They come up the course together, these two French girls, and this is absolutely crucial for them to win. And you'll see the technique emerging as these two strapping sisters, Françoise and Véronique Moreau, come up. Two big girls, they have to come up the course. The technique is to come together. And he's got to head the balls out. 4 so far. 5. He headed one out. The secret is both arrive together. And as you see, the two girls are chained round the waist to elastic belts. And the elastic's very, very strong indeed. These girls are making the game look rather easy, but look at the size of them. The one on the right is about 5'10". The one on the left is about 5'9". The strapping Muro sisters. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 balls. The game is a minute long, and the seconds are stretching out for us like agony, because Sandwell don't play this game, and that's the end of it. How many balls have they got? You see the game, you see the size of the French girls. 6 balls for France. And that is a good score, I'll tell you.
Na startu, možemo li početi? Si,
Achtung!
Now will go the two German girls, the Frenchman there, and the luck of the draw, would you believe, this guy is a volleyball expert. As you know, in international knockout, you're not allowed to select your competitor per game. He is drawn on the morning of the match. But this guy is an ace volleyballer. So not only will he be well balanced, but he'll be able to head balls as well. The two girls coming up together in unison. This is the game, but you see, they've got to be accurate. And it's agony for us. The French have played and got 6. We've 5 more teams to go, but not Britain. And not only is he expert at heading, but the German girls can't throw. Only 3. And I think already this marvellous crowd of Yugoslavs here in Zemun are aware that it's a two-horse race. And something, unless something dramatic happens, it's the French and the British for the competition. 5 seconds to go and only 3 balls in. Bad news for Britain, good news for Fontainebleau.
Go for Germany, 3 balls.
Lanstein, 3 lopte.
Just 3 for the Germans. Now we'll go Altdorf. That little town, as you know, up on the way to the Gotthard Pass, nearly on the summit, the birthplace of William Tell. Beautiful little town on the actual summit of the Gotthard is that famous ski resort of Andermatt. But what about these girls? Throwing at the Italian. One in. The Yugoslav crowd, silent at the moment, but prepared to emote at the drop of the hat. Very, very sporting crowd here in Zemun, this suburb of Belgrade, 100,000 population. But well catered for in sporting clubs, by the way, in Zemun. 47 sports clubs they have, and 22 school societies with 12,000 active members. Nuts on sport, the little town of Zemun on the banks of the Blue River Danube. And they're applauding this Italian. He's letting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. One more would be handy for us, but he hasn't. They haven't got it, and the French are still in the lead.
Igraj za ekipu iz Aldorfa. Koliko lopti, čini mi se 5.
Yes, the score for Switzerland, 5 balls.
Aldorf, 5 lopti.
Gennaro's English, good enough for us, good enough for you.
Tutto a posto.
The Italians.
Cominciamo.
Attenzione.
Versus the Belgian goalkeeper. Well, they're very excited, the Italian girls, but oh, beautiful bit of backward heading by that Belgian goalkeeper. He's a student of social science, this guy, the Belgian. rather flimsy-looking pins, but he's effective, and the girls haven't got it together. This is easy meat for him. Oh, dear. And you can see now how strong those French girls were. These are two rather tiny Italian girls being affected by the elastic. And what's more, the couple... Scone pum pum. They're coming separately. They must come together to fox him, because it's time to head them out. Watch this. Child's play. Only one for the Italians, and by now they'll lose heart. The crowd sympathetic.
Attention. 5 seconds.
Only 5 seconds to go, and only one ball for Italy. Tolfa. One more team to go. That's the Belgian team. We don't play, but it was rather important. In exasperation, the Italian throws the ball to terra firma, and the pronouncement.
Only one ball. One.
Tolfa, siamo jedna lopta.
The Yugoslavs to go, then the Belgians, as you were.
Na redu su Zemunci.
Pasnja, pasnja. 3, 2, 1.
Bebadjeden. 1, 2, 3. Oh, and the German. The German doing well. These two girls by now must know how to do the game. Well, they won the Joker game. Well, they came second on the Joker game, rather, to Britain in the last game. Zemun not doing too badly. It's a big hefty piece on the right. But he's good, this fella. He's a little technician, this German. They must come together, throw together. And he's... Oh! A touch of the back and bars. Clever stuff. And the applause here. The applause here for them. And look at that in the background. You see the two French girls there on the right of the picture. They are smiling and applauding every time this German puts on this display. A display there of calisthenics, and he's very pleased with himself. And the French are too. You see them applauding on the right. The two big girls.
For Yugoslavia, we have 4 balls.
4 for Yugoslavia. Still in the lead, Fontainebleau.
We put once again inside.
The Belgians to go.
La Belgique, attention. 3, 2, 1.
Opposing the Swiss. No, they must throw together. If the balls come one at a time, it's child's play. And these two girls are fairly big. They should do something. No, no. Only two. Attention to the time. 25 seconds to go, only two. They're behind Fontainebleau. These two must go in to count. They've tied for 2 more runs, if they're quick. 3 in. They could possibly do it. They could do it. They're waiting for each other. Yes, no, they're 4 in. On this next run, they've exactly 12 seconds to make the run. If these two go in, they will only tie for first place with Fontainebleau. No, they've had it. They've no time to make another run. I don't care what happens. And the French will pick up 6 points. And once again, their positions on the scoreboard will be reversed. First Fontainebleau, then Sanwell, then Sanwell, then Fontainebleau. Here comes the pronouncement.
Lì, 4 lopte, kao ekipa Zemuna.
The points, France, 6 points.
There they go.
Francuska, Fontainebleau, 6.
Switzerland, 5 points.
Aldor, 5.
Yugoslavia, 4 points.
Zemun, 4.
Belgium, exequo, 4 points.
Sili, isto toliko, 4.
Germany, 2 points.
Wanstein, 2.
And Italy, 1 point.
Itolfa, 1.
And now you see the printout yet again. Fontainebleau at the top. There's the fanfare. Fontainebleau 29, Sanwell 26, and a most important Phil Rougetti.
And it is. 1 minute 45 seconds could decide the ultimate winner. Sanwell to go with Judith Gowan, Steve Millard, Peter Reynolds, Raymond Morris, Hazel Harmon. I give you the name because they're going to be so important now to get 12 at least. Will pass Fontainebleau, and anything after that would be a bonus. It's very important. 7-pointer. Started well, not dropping many passes. Steve Millard in the swing boat. Peter Reynolds is the pusher. And Raymond Morris in the second. And there's some of the fans. I don't think that... Oh, there they are. They're giving it all they can to get it. It's a knockout. Or is a knockout according to that? Well, time will tell whether it will be a knockout. Because if they win this, I think we're on to our first win this season. Bath was third place, Kruen Nantwich fifth, and Londonderry third place. To give you a guideline. We reckon with the past the 11, could be 12, so bonus is now, with every one of these footballs going in, it's a bonus to stop the last two, because obviously the last team will be very keen to knock something off to this. Marvellous stocking. I've never seen so many footballs in a stocking. 10 seconds to add one or two, and they're doing it so correctly, not dropping any passes. And the long stocking there is going to provide a real bonus in this international heat. And the music went well, but we want the number of balls, and we are reckoning 19. See how right we are. 19, you can hear the crowd, the Sandwell mob, really enjoying this moment, which could be the deciding part, but two games still to go, Stuart.
Well, thank you, Eddie. We come now to the blindfold night game. Six blindfold knights and six girls mounted on their backs with lances akimbo. They have to go up the course and spear a ring. Pat Jones is on the back of John Collins. Away they go up the course. The lances up in the night sky. And you see the rings there have to be pierced. And the last one to finish, the last one to get a ring, will be eliminated. Well, in fact, there isn't a ring for the last one. Pat Jones on the back of John Collins, and we need to be in contention because Fontainebleau are breathing right down our necks. They're fighting neck and neck for it. Pat Jones, a big girl, a great competitor. Remember her at Charnock, Richard. She won the event for Sandwell in the sack race on the replay against Stevenage. Pat Jones, a marvellous competitor. And she's just about in. The last one will be eliminated. You see the knights, the stout legs coming underneath the costume. They're completely blindfolded. The only way they can essay their way up the course is from instruction by the rider on the back. The horse, Sir Percy, and Belgium don't lash the withers.
On the fifth place. Evo dakle, ekipa Silija i ekipa Zemuna na petom mestu.
So, attention. We've lost two teams, but Britain are still racing. We're in trap two. We're last off. We didn't hear the whistle. We've got to get a ring, Pat. We must have one. We missed it. Oh, we've gone. We've been burned off. The Swiss are still in. The Germans are still in. The French are still there.
So we have
gone.
Britain on the fourth place.
On the
Sandwell na
Chetum on that run, we're in fourth place. Well, the French are still racing, and this is absolutely critical for us. Zemun and the Belgians went on the first round, and we've gone on the next round. Three teams set off, only two rings to go. We could do with the French going out on this round. The French are last away. Up go the Swiss, then the Germans. The Germans are coming in. Could they get the French one? They have! They beat the French! So it got as bad as all that. A consoling tap from the French damsel to the French knight. And it's good news for us, because the French are in third place. Sandwell are in fourth. And with that fantastic fil rouge, Sandwell must be emerging now as the clear favourites on this beautiful night in Yugoslavia. Sit back and enjoy it.
Attention.
The last round, the Swiss and the Germans. Up to the end, a smack on the withers from the judge there. Oh, and the Swiss are away. Straight in. What's going to happen? Will it be the Swiss or the German? The ring's dodging about. They both got it. No, the Swiss have got it. Swiss have got it first. Altdorfer, please. A few smiles, yeah, lovely costume.
Switzerland on the first place and Germany on the second place.
Swiss are first place, Germany second place. French are third, the British are fourth. And let's have a look at it. 6 points for Aldorf.
Germany 5 points.
5 points for Landstein.
France 4 points.
4 points
Fontainebleau,
for Fontainebleau. 3 points.
3 points.
Sandwell 3.
We're still there. We're still racing. We're looking good.
Silly 2.
And let's have a look at the printout.
2 points.
Here it comes. With a little fanfare.
Thank you.
The Yugoslavs a bit of a threat, but still the two clear favourites at the top. The French 33, the British 29, and Eddie.
Well, Tolfa not really in contention. They're at the bottom there, but they could be difficult if they got 20, because we can't lose one spot. We being, of course, Sandwell, and we must admit to a certain amount of bias, because it would be nice to get a first, and this Sandwell team has shown a lot of ability and courage here in this very excitable stadium. And Tolfa to go. Just give it a mention, those of you who like to follow this, 35 miles northwest of Rome, famous for crafts, especially leather goods, and a very wealthy town. And the boys and girls who are taking part, one's a council worker and four students. So one's in at the moment. You know the game, I'm sure. Dropping it down to the man in the boat across the front. Chess was never like this, I'm sure, in Zemun. And they play a lot of it. And the Blue Danube has figured prominently on the music scene. Three, I think. One dropped. If they can finish under 19, which I think they will, then all is well with Sandwell's fight for a first. And one must give a lot of credit to the supporters who have come along and really given heart to them at every possible opportunity. He's for Tolfa. Cheer for Tolfa, he says. Do right. Cheer there at the bottom. They need some encouragement. 30 seconds to go. 2, 4, 6, 7, 8. The Sandwell 19, and the last team to go is, of course, the hometown team. 10 seconds to go, so Sandwell safe, I reckon, but probably they could come second, could Tolfa, in this particular Phil Rouge, 14, with just Yugoslavia to go before we can say for sure that Sandwell have got the maximum fill route, 0.7, and Stewart.
Thank you, Eddie. In comes the German joker on a game we call the Thursday night game. And there are the two jockeys from Great Britain and Sandwell, Anne Keithley and Judy Cowan. Anne Keithley's got all the work to do, because on Anne's back is a bucket, a 5-litre bucket. And it's a game this in two heats. The Italians, the Belgians and the British are going. The jockeys have to go up the course, as you see, under the hurdles, over the obstacles, and we're going like lightning. That is Anne Keithley. Anne Keithley was a PE teacher, and on the top there, you see, with the pump, a young man called Colin Dewis. He has to fill that bucket full of water. And then she has to come back down the course, and unfortunately for the girls, they're on a travelling band. When the girls think they've got enough water in the bucket, they go back up the course the way they came. Sandwell, wanting to make a name. 300,000 people live in Sandwell, and you've never heard of them before. The total area there is 21,000 acres, centred right in the heart of the Black Country, a major industrial centre. Sandwell. The main town, of course, is West Bromwich, and the main football team, West Bromwich Albion. Now, the crucial thing is, does Anne Keithley have enough water in that bucket to win this game? She takes it, and there's Judy Cowan. What a great competitor she is. A real impish little smile, everything she does. Strong as a horse, totally extrovert. They call her Judd, but that's Anne Keithley. Jumping well, on the top. A little bell will sound after 1 minute, which tells you you've got 30 seconds to get back up the course and pour the water in the measuring. Oh, Anne looks to have a lot of water there. There are the Belgians, and next to them the Italians. There's the bell, you've 1 minute to go, and back up the course she goes. Now, it's important now not to spill any. Over the hurdle, on hands and knees, and a little bumps a daisy. She's doing well. It's a good run, this, with by Anne Keithy, but how much water has she got in? It looks good. Watch that very carefully. How much does Judd put in? Quite a quantity. It's a measuring job. Because the French are going in the second heat with those marvellous competitors. She's no time. It's a two-run job. This is absolutely crucial to us. Because it's clear that Sandwell and Fontainebleau are the main contestants.
The score at the end of the game only,
oh, he's making a suspense.
In the due order, well, following the measure.
We are absolutely crossing our fingers and legs and whatever else we've got across in the commentary box that we have done well in this game. They are not going to judge the game. But there you can see for yourself, we've got about what? About seven marks. We've won the first heat. That's for sure. We've won the first heat. We've come in the points. Now, can we win the whole game? Because watch the French girls on the far side. In the middle, the Germans. On the near side, the Swiss. Not as agile as Anne for Sandwell. But watch that big girl on the far side for France. Once again, it's the Moreau sister. This is Françoise, the bigger of the two, nearly 6 feet tall. She is not getting a lot of water in the bucket. The Swiss girl is balancing best. The one thing that Anne was good at was getting water in the bucket. That French girl does not appear to be getting as much water as we did, and we are hoping that she doesn't. It's a game, this, of nerves. You've got to judge yourself as the competitor when to make the move back up the course. They made the move. Now, is she going to come back with the contents intact? It looks like a full tank to me. It's a 5-litre bucket. That's exactly 1 gallon. She's spilling some. The French girl's spilling some. Watch on the far side, because that's the competitor to watch. There's the bell to go, and she may have misjudged the run altogether. She may have gambled on one run. She won't have time to make two. There's the bell. There's only half a minute to go. This could be absolutely fantastic for Sandwell, because the French, I think, have misjudged it. I think they've misjudged the run. They could have made two runs, hung on two, late at the far end. What a lovely shot that is from the top of the game. But there's the French girl in position. She's got to judge a run now. She must go. There's the bell. She's got to go now. And she's there. Oh, and a lot of water is not going in that bucket. The German coming over. The Swiss will be coming on the near side. We're ignoring them for the time being. Whether we're making a mistake or not, we don't know. But we really fancy Sandwell tonight for our first British win, not only in this season, but of last. 5 seconds to go. And here comes the little Swiss girl. And she's missed it. She's mistimed it as well. Too late for Switzerland. The French have got in. They made a run. Silence descends on the stadium right on the banks of the Danube, and we think we may have come in second place. The Swiss may have won it. The Swiss. What have we got? Now, this is absolutely vital. The Italians could come in. They have to wait for it to settle. But certainly we're there. We could have come in. We could have come in second place. I think the Belgians have won it. The Belgians on the right. There's Hubert, the French judge. What's he got? 7. I think the Belgians have beaten us on the right. But Britain come in second, I'm sure of that. A lot of tension here now. You could hear a pin drop. 10,000 people waiting for the pronouncement. In centimetres, what have we got in centimetres? 23. 23 for Belgium, it looks like. 23. Definitely, it's Belgium, Britain, Italy, Germany, Switzerland, and France are last. So they pick up only one point that really opens up the way now for Sandwell to barge ahead on that marvellous fil rouge they've had. Sandwell will take the lead yet again. The lead has changed from the first game onwards. What a fantastic, exciting night it is.
Great Britain,
so 23 centimetres for Sandwell, the Belgians. Sandwell have 22, Italy, well done, 19, and Keithley and Judd Gowan.
Tolfa
come next with 19.
France, 14. For France. Germany,
17.4 for Germany. The Swiss look like 17, and what marvellous news it is.
The points,
and watch it yet again. Once more, we go into the lead.
Great Britain, 5
No, we don't. We share the lead with Fontainebleau. 34 points apiece. You've never had such a nail-biting finish in your life. Two absolutely fantastic teams of K-Live, the opposition. Can Sandwell do it? They're biting the nails, and so are we in the commentary box, and I'm sure you are at home round the telly tonight. Fantastic competition here. First time in Yugoslavia. Can it be won by Britain? Fontainebleau, 34. Sandwell, 34. The Belgians, 27. The Swiss, 27. And Eddie with you.
And the last of the Phil Rude and the home team, Zemun, to go. What are we concerned with, really? And I'm sure you are, the fact that the Sandwell 19 could carry them through and could be such an important part now to winning this competition, where the excitement is so high, the crowd are very, very lively, and it's a very, as they say, a balmy night, but only in the weather sense. So what are they going to get? One across, see if we can count them. That was dropped, so that was a good pass to drop. Just looking off at the moment. They're missing out on the first one in, which is good for Sandwell. Great Britain chasing an important first place for the first time in this competition. Three. We'll try and count them down. 1 minute 45 seconds, the time allotted. The warming up. Four. After three knock-ons, they're now taking the pass carefully and putting it over the try line. And everyone gets a cheer. 30 seconds. They're getting applause from the home crowd, but they're not going to do it. It's going to be a 7-pointer for Sandwell. And then it's going to be, of course, all on the last game. But the last Phil Rude, Zemun, the home team, and she's getting annoyed about it. Because they're making a bold bid, the 10 seconds, and they're getting into double figures. And I don't know the count that, but I reckon 13. 13 or 14. We'll soon get it. From Guido Pancaldi. 13 or 14. What is it? The last ball was good. 13. So Sandwell are going to take first position.
So, the point we have for Great Britain, 7 points.
7 points for Great Britain.
Then we have Italy, 6 points.
Italy, 6 points.
6 points for Italy. Then Yugoslavia.
Yugoslavia, Zemun's hometown team, 5 points. You get in very good cheer from their fans, seeing knockout life for the first time. Well, just on frontier, I should say. France, 4 points. And Switzerland, also 4 points.
2 points.
2 points to Belgium, and a rather low score for Germany, who often won this competition. 2 points. So this is the situation. Sandwell 41, Fontainebleau 38. That's the only two that count, as far as we're concerned. And it's all on the last game with Stewart.
Well, thank you, Eddie. The fanfare, could it be the fanfare for Great Britain? This last game concerns yet again the chess, because the knight has to make a pawn. On the starting line, we have seven knights, and furthest away from us, we have Paul Lippert, who is our knight. As you see, in front of them are poles. Those poles will go backwards as fast as possible, and they have to take off the knight's costume and finish as a pawn. The adversaries are winding those poles back towards them. In other words, they will go to the right-hand side of the screen. Seven knights, and we have to finish in the first three. We have to finish in the first three, and away, you see, that's the adversary winding back the pole as the knights pop up and put on the elements onto the pole. There are five elements to build the pawn. You've got to build the pawn. To change the knight into a pawn figuratively, you've got to change your knight's costume into a pawn's costume by building the pawn. Five elements. And every element you put on, you have to go back to the start and come back again with another element. Let's have a look at the British one. On the far side, we are in the lead. There's no doubt about that. And where are the French? Because they're the main challenge to us, and that's the element coming back again. That's the pole. The Belgians have got three on. The Yugoslavs have three, but where are the British? It's the far side. We finished it. That's the British pawn, and that's Paul Lippert, our PE teacher, who made a mess of that game on roller skates. He's going to be the hero of the night because he has finished. He's built his pawn in limit time. He's come back. He has to illuminate a sign. His sign says the letter A on it. There's a Latin motto which is lit up at the end of the game. There it is, they finished. The French have finished too. The French were next to us. They finished, and I think they finished in second place. They pursued us all the way home. What a fantastic finish in Yugoslavia. That, as you see, the signals are going up, the flags are unfurling, and halfway up the flagpoles, you see the letters which will be illuminated when everybody's finished. In the meanwhile, the Belgians are coming forward with the last element of the pawn. And if he doesn't put it on before it reaches the final line, then that's elimination. But no doubt about it, Britain have finished in first place. 7 points for Paul Lippert and Sandwell. We're losing our voices here. It's 48 points for Sandwell. Concluding, of course, that everything has gone well and there's been no disqualification. But there's the sign going up. It's Gens Una Sumus. And that's Latin for we are all one people. The Yugoslavs have created some history tonight by staging the first international Jeux Sans Frontières here, and it's been won by Britain. Sandwell from the black country have come here and they've conquered with charm and with effort, with strength, with stamina, with will, and it's a very popular win. There's no doubt about it, but they've been pursued all the way by this fantastic team of Fontainebleau. Fontainebleau, a side comprising army personnel, they came to win, to represent France in Montecatini later on. But first of all, the positions. Let's see, we're first! Yes, that's it! And you can hear the cheers from the Brits. Ooh, and it was close.
Switzerland third.
So we'll finish with 47, the French with 44, and the rest are nowhere at all. And there's the readout. And whilst it's being read out, we're all celebrating up here, including, of course, Uncle Eddie.
Well, it's been a night of nights, if you understand what I mean, and I'm sure it's going to be a late night, not only for the British team, but possibly some of the backers too. It's a moment to cherish. Sandwell at the top, 41. Fontainebleau 38, and Sandwell have been really good in this competition. They've trained well, they've looked good, the enthusiasm has been so good all the time. And here's the final thing coming up, Sandwell 48, a joy to see. Fontainebleau 44, Holder 36, Silly 33, Zemun 33, Lahnstein 25, Tolfer 20. So there it is. Next week, East Kilbride play in France, but there's the joyous moment for the Sandwell supporters. So from me, good night.
And they're celebrating there. You see Pat Jones there as the camera. Big Colin coming in from the right. there. Everybody's celebrating, a wonderful team. There's Jeff Ellis, the team captain, winking away with a slightly balding dome. There are the supporters with the Union Jack, and they're getting a silver trophy. It's the first silver trophy we've had in 2 years. It's vitally important. 48 points will take a lot of beating, as Eddie says. Now we'll have the awarding of the trophy in the background, the joyous crowd, and if there's one thing the Yugoslavs wanted tonight, it was a Yugoslav win. Second was a British win. We are very popular in Yugoslavia. 22 million people live in Yugoslavia. A lot of expatriates live. Expatriate Yugoslavs live in Great Britain. There's the team in front of the castle. There's Sandy Dallas with the great big bear, the lady team captain. On her right, Jeff Ellis. The boys and girls wearing the false moustaches. It's been well costumed, but they're in the track. There's the silver trophy, and it must feel like the FA Cup to Sandwell. They haven't been beaten yet in competition. They won at Wolverhampton. They won the championship at Charnock Richard, and now they've won in Yugoslavia. Will they go forward to Monte Cotini, or will the points 48 be beaten? But whatever, from us all here, we're exultant. It's a fond good night for the first time from Yugoslavia. Nema zavisti. Ekipa Zemuna sakupila 33 boda, to je drugi rezultat među našim ekipama. Ekipa Splita je za sad najbolja sa 30.